Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from DirectQ. A while ago, I did a video talking about case sensitivity and database names and how it affects the SQL that's being generated that's sent into your source. And towards the end of that video, I mentioned, hey, you can run into these same things when you're using DirectQuery and Import. And I thought about it and I was like, I should do a video to kind of validate everything. And a few people commented and was like, yeah, we want to see that video. So I decided to do a video. So enough of all this talking. You know, I like to do. Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. Let's say, for example, you have a model that looks like this. You have all your dimension tables in import mode, and then you have your fact table in direct query mode because it's so much data in it. And you're like, I don't want to import it all. We're okay with how direct query performs. When I have my slicers in import mode, they don't have to go back and issue queries. So you're minimizing the round trips to the source. And so that's fine. But whenever you combine columns from your import tables with your direct query tables, you notice that it's not that fast. And you even look at the queries being sent to the source and you're like, wait, these queries are awful. How do I fix this? And I'm going to show you why, and I'm going to show you how to fix it. So you set this up. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn on my handy DAX studio because I want to show you what the query looks like I did in the other video. And so we'll go here and we're going to turn on all queries. Okay, our trace is running. And I'm gonna switch over to the other page so this query will run and it's actually sending some DAX to the source. And then we'll go over to DAX Studio. I mean, we'll turn off all queries and turn on server timings. We'll get that query and we're gonna run that query. So let's run that query so we can see what happens to server timings. So when it's finished, if you watch the first video that I did when I was talking about two different sources with direct query, this server timing should look very familiar to you. First it goes out, gets the information from product, then it gets the information from internet sales, then it combines them into one query. And if you want to see what the query looks like, right click and choose raw query, then you can see, right, that join is on the product key because that's how the relationship between the product table and the internet sales table is set up, is on product key. So it materializes that table. Yes, it does the exact same thing because Power BI thinks it's two different sources and it can't create a very elegant join for you. Okay. Now, how do you fix this problem? So what you would do is I'm gonna head back over to Power BI and I'm in a different model. What you would do is you would switch your tables to dual mode. So you would just click here, go to advanced, change the storage mode to dual. Now, what this means is that this table can act in both storage modes. It can be direct query or it could be import. If I don't mingle it with any other columns, in other words, if I don't create a visual that only use columns from my table that's in dual mode, it's gonna hit the cache. So it's not gonna send queries back to the source. For example, if I make a slicer using one of the table that's in dual mode, it won't go back to the source. But if I make a visual, say a table or a column chart, for example, that uses a column from the product table and a measure that references a column in that internet sales table, which is in direct query mode, it's gonna send a SQL statement back. But let me show you how elegant that SQL statement is written. And I'm gonna do one more thing before we do that. I'm gonna turn on referential integrity just so it does an inner join. So let's do this. So we're gonna go back to the report. We're gonna fire up DAX Studio. We're going to repeat those steps. So we're going to turn on all queries. There we go. Get our trace running. Switch back over to the report. Go to that page. Let the report run. It's a direct query because what I've done is I've created a visual that's using a column from my table that's in dual mode and a measure that references columns in my fact table, which is in direct query mode. If I switch over to DAX Studio, double click on that measure, turn off all queries, turn on server timings, wait for my server timings to start running, click run, go over to server timings, give it a little bit, queries finished. And now you can see it's a single query, single storage engine query, and it's a much more elegant query that it produced. And if I go to raw query here, you'll see that it's done a really good job. I don't think I pressed apply on my referential integrity. That's why it's doing the left outer join. But nevertheless, it's not materializing the table. It's actually doing a join on the two tables in the source because now it can recognize both tables are from the same source. All right, what do you think? Have you run into this before? Are you using this method? I'd love to know. You know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If you want to learn more about Power BI, about DAX, about Fabric, take a look at the video that's flying over my head. It's probably something that you can watch. And as always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.